Hello, I am Mrs. Geeta Zunjarwad, Assistant Professor of Communication Skills, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we are going to discuss about the importance of goals and goal settings. At the end of this session, student will be able to understand the importance of goals and goal setting for personal and professional success. Everybody in this world has a different set of circumstances, different set of skills, and a different set of opportunities through which they can interact with the world and find their unique sense of fulfillment. Your mission in life should be to figure out what your unique sets are and how you can take action to best capitalize on them that gives all of your effort, purpose and meaning. So goals are the guiding light that you get there. In this session, today we are going to discuss what is goal, importance of goals in life, types of goals, what is goal setting, and golden rules of goal setting. So let us discuss about the definition of goal. Goal is a desired result that a person plans and commit to achieve. Some of the other definitions: an aim or objective towards which an endeavor is directed, or a goal is simply a target which an individual or organization intends to reach or achieve. Now let us discuss about what is the importance of goal in our life. Take a pause, think about the question and write the answer. Now let us discuss about why goals are important. Earl Nightingale has said, "People with goals succeed because they know where they are going." So these are some of the important points why goals are important. So first one is, goals help to bring out the best in us. It helps you focus and use the energy and attention in a meaningful way and accomplish things without wastage of energy and time. The second one is, goals help to believe in us. It makes you work with full potential, bringing out the best in you. The next point is, goals give long-term vision and short-term motivation. They give you motivation to achieve something, and achievement brings you content and respect from others. The next point is, goal gives a purpose to live and direction to move ahead. When you have a destination, you start moving, or at least try to move. When there is no goal, you remain floating. The next point is, goals allow us to measure our progress. Each goal is like a single step of a stairs. And the last one is, as you reach and climb over more goals, you get a feeling of improvement, or else if there were no goals, you will feel stagnant and depressed. There are the two types of goals, short-term goals and long-term goals. Now let us discuss about the short-term goal. Short-term goal is something you want to do in the near future. The near future can mean today, this week, this month, or even this year. A short-term goal is something you want to accomplish soon. And examples are to take a class or to buy a new television or to write my resume. Now, the long-term goals. A long-term goal is something you want to do further in future. Long-term goals usually take 12 months or more to achieve. And the examples are to be graduated from college, to save for retirement, or having my own business. According to Tony Robbins, setting goals is the first step in turning the invisible into the visible. To achieve goals, much has been written on the importance of goals and their relationship to success and happiness. But how many of us practice this on a daily basis? To set a goal, you need to decide what is that you want to accomplish. To help keep me focused on achieving my goals, I follow some simple steps. Practice this and I believe it will help to propel you towards the success to which you aspire. These are some of the golden rules of setting goals. Set goals that motivate you. Set SMART goals. Set goals in writing. Make an action plan. Stick with it. Make a list of steps. Examine your goals periodically. Develop your skill set and work on your goals. Now let us discuss about in detail. The first one is set goals that motivate you. When you set goals for yourself, it is important that they motivate you. This means making sure that they are important to you and that there is value in achieving them. Set goals that relate to the high priorities in your life. The second one is set SMART goals. SMART means S stands for specific, M stands for measurable, A stands for attainable, R stands for relevant, and T stands for time-based or time-bounded. Now let us the goals as a SMART in detail. Specific means your goals must be clear and well-designed. Measurable means in your goals, you can measure your degree of success. Attainable, make sure that it's possible to achieve the goals you set. Relevant, goals should be relevant to the direction you want your life and career to take. And the time-bound or time-based, your goals must have a deadline. This is the best example of my SMART goal. The next golden rule is set goals in writing. Writing out your goals is your commitment to achieving the goal. Writing a goal is a powerful statement. It is the promise to yourself to pay attention to the accomplishment of the goal. The next one is make an action plan. Devote as much time as you need to find a goal or goals. After finding a goal that you really desire to achieve, draw up a plan, being as practical as possible. Writing out an action plan with due dates makes the goal even more powerful and you will realize that you are making progress towards your ultimate goal. The next golden rule is stick with it. Goal setting is an ongoing activity and not just a means to an end. So build in reminders to keep yourself on track and make regular time slots available to review your goals. Always keep the end result in focus. Maintain your excitement and enthusiasm and keep moving forward. See each difficulty you meet as an opportunity for learning and growth. Next one is make a list of steps. List the steps you need to take, such as signing up for a course, studying, reading, developing the required skills, looking for a job, etc. Steps you need to implement that will take you closer to achieving your goal. The next one is examine your goals periodically. Some goals aren't worth achieving. Circumstances and people change. Some goals lose their importance. It is a good idea to re-examine your goals regularly and weed out the worthless ones. The next one is develop your skill set. Figure out what new knowledge you will need or what new skills you will have to develop. Find out the best source of gaining this knowledge and invest wisely to develop the asset you need. The last one is work on your mindset. Develop a positive glass half full approach to every aspect of your life, including your thought about how you will achieve your goals. Read inspirational books, hang out with other motivated people, and believe in your own abilities. Work on your own attitude at every opportunity. Remember, goals become fruitful only if you try hard. Try hard to work to reach them and execute them, else they just remain in your mind. So turn your dreams into goals and climb the ladder of success. Set a goal and reach it. Be happy. Here I have given some references, whatever I have used for my presentation.